right? So it is basically the thing for that. So I'll just summarize in a first of all, it should be discoverable across the globe so that people will know about what exactly we are doing. The second one is we need to enable a mechanism so that if somebody wanted to directly contribute to our cause, maybe as a volunteer, maybe as a, you know, money point of view, they can directly do that. We need an online legitimacy. So these days, if you don't have a website, people think, you know, you're not legit at all. So definitely we need a website for that particular thing. Education and awareness of your work, basically, you know, the point has already been spoken about. It will show your 24/7 presence, like, you know, you are there on that particular place. And it is basically a pocket-friendly and eco-friendly thing also. So these are the couple of reasons. There are more through which, you know, we need a website. But, you know, these are the ones which is essential to have for the, basically for the NGO aspects also. Now, what comes in the mind when you think about free website? Like, you know, whenever we think about free website, we'll get, you know, about the website tools. So generally there are Wix in the world, Weebly and the WordPress. So these are the platforms generally provide, you know, those kind of free access altogether. And you can just build very easily on these kind of platforms. So there's the one thing, okay, what these websites or what are the things we are missing in this world is whenever we are designing a website about 6 different parameters, like, you know, the audience, the SEO, the page loading speed, mobile usability, content and conversion rate optimization. Now this is again a question for everyone. What exactly you guys understand with these terminologies? Anybody is familiar with them? Anything? Like, if you can just say yes or no, it will be great. Yeah. That's good. Great. So basically, you know, these are the things, you know, which needs to be there in any website. But whenever you are creating in a system where, you know, you need to do everything from the scratch, at that time, you need to consider all those points. The first one is audience, that what kind of audience and the people you are catering to. The second thing is SEO, like search engine optimization. You need to have an off-page and on-page SEOs all together. Then your page loading speed, like, you know, your website having a very fast speed altogether. It should be a mobile user because, you know, majority of the people are using through the mobile. And we should have a very relevant content, right keyword, so that, you know, it will help in SEO also and so that people will understand and simplifying it. And the last but not the least, the conversion rate optimization. So your website having all those parameters intact, and you should understand that how exactly these conversion rate optimization will happen. Okay, so these are the high level topic which, you know, you will be requiring while even designing a website. So here is a concept, okay, we call it as intelligent websites. Okay, so there are a lot of places where, you know, you can get a website, but there is not a single place where you can get a intelligent website, which is very much optimized automatically for you and serve it better. So these intelligent website having their audience build, they have their SEOs, they have their, you know, fastest paging loading speed, mobile usability, content and conversion rate optimization all together, right? The other thing what an intelligent website having is, you know, chat support. They can data capturing so that they can show the analytics as well as what kind of things are happening on your platform or your website altogether. And the most important thing is regionalization. Okay. That, you know, the website should have their own regionalization power altogether. Okay. So for that, how we can do that particular thing is we have certain things which will be definitely useful for you, which is as a do-it-yourself platform. Okay. So I'll just brief about, you know, Crowdera as an ecosystem altogether, where, you know, Crowdera as a company will provide you the, you know, those intelligent website which you can make from the scratch and you need not to do anything. What exactly Crowdera will have? So they will have a crowdfunding platform where, you know, you can basically get things done. They have a workplace giving solution and they have an enterprise fundraising SaaS-based solution also, and a couple of other vertical what they have. The most important thing is where exactly the Yogi.ai comes is their proprietary artificial intelligence thing, where it will not only provide assistance to build these kind of website landing pages and campaigns, but also it will contextually personalize as per your demography, where exactly you are and what kind of audience you wanted to cater. Even we will go to the wealth screening level also. And the last one is the experience of a website, that, you know, how people are interacting with that particular thing, right? So the last part is, you know, in case of global compliant thing, you know, how exactly people can do a regionalization. So a platform, what exactly Crowdera has built on the website angle, is automatically globally compliant in terms of fundraise and for the reach, and also it has a regional compliances as per regional law and regional languages. Okay, so these are the very simple pages which you can do it by then and there, right? So that's how, you know, things can be done on a Crowdera platform. Is there any question till now? Hello.
Yeah, Agam, I have a question.
Yeah.
So if an NGO or non-profit needs this kind of solution, who will be the front ending, Crowdera or your AI organization? I think it will be Crowdera.
Yeah, it will be Crowdera.
Okay. So
Yeah, so it's a very simple thing, right? You know, so Crowdera having their do-it-yourself platform, you just need to go there.
Yeah.
And you can directly go to the login process. And everything you will get in the now and then only, right? So if you want it, I'll just showcase. Can you see my screen here?
Yes, we can.
Right. Okay. So this is the do-it-yourself part in the interface of Crowdera altogether. You just need to go and create your own organization. You just click on India, right? Let's say XYZ, or you just need to select a category, and all these categories are UNSDG aligned. Simply you can do, you can select multiple things. You can upload a logo, let's say. And you can write something about, we are happy to help, right? So you do this there, okay. Just click from here, Nepal Connect. So you just need to select that. What are you, like, registered NGO or just a company? So let's say, if it's a company, limited liability, I'll just enter some random name. I'll just load, let's say, like, you know, flow. Okay, it's too long. So, okay, let's say if this will take up, not taking up. I hope this will take up. Yeah, so you can do, you can add all the bank detail and everything from this particular thing. And I'll just showcase that, you know, how exact. So I'm not going to submit because I don't have these details already met. I'll just showcase that, you know, how exactly an organization will look like at the end. So this is a Happy Animal website. You can just go through it. And this is how, you know, your first landing page will look like. And, you know, your initiatives, who are the change maker behind it, what a change maker will do, and all those things. So it's a 3 to 4 minute process where you can create your own website altogether, right? Now, there is a thing. Like, if you wanted to change the domain name, Okay, and if you wanted to change the whole formatting and all those kind of thing, you can directly sign up for the pro plan of Cloudera, right? So that's where they will assist you and they will provide all the thing that you know how exactly a website can be made. Now, these donate button and everything is, you know, the payment orchestration system is that world's best already integrated. So you need not to do anything. The website's having a shareable feature. Not only that, but you can basically email it, LinkedIn, Twitter, WhatsApp, wherever you wanted to go at. If you wanted to run a campaign and those kind of thing, again, you can run a campaign in a beautiful manner, right? And these kind of campaign page, you will get it anyways. If you wanted to, so this campaign is basically ended. You can basically share, you can embed this kind of widget in small, large, medium forms also. And you will get it on your website, your web pages, and wherever you want it to done. Right. So that's the way you can quickly create that thing, the website basically. So if you have any question, you know, love to take that.
Yagam, there is a question from Shankar Rao. Is it independent domain or subdomain? So I think you said for an independent domain, you need to go pro.
Yeah, so it's like the pro plan is also not that costly at all. So it will cost you like $10, not more than that. So still a great deal to have. But yes, initially, if you go, it will be a subdomain. But for independent, you can go ahead for the pro plan.
Correct. And there is a question from Dr. Sylvia Cole. It is, do we accept soup and will we have a Cloudera website address? So I can answer the first one. No, you will not be accessing this through TechSoup. And the second part, Agam.
Yeah, so the website I'm the writing, it's a gocrowdera.com. So I'll be just putting on a chat.
And I think you can also have your own domain also.
Yeah.
And then you don't need to go through gocrowdera.com. I think that will be pinned directly towards that.
Yeah, definitely. So in terms of, you know, if you get access to TechSoup, that's on Jaideep. And but you know, happy to help anytime for that case.
There's a question from Prakash Upreti. He says, do we need to buy domain from Cloudera or can we change a records of other domain provider?
Yeah. So domain is on you. Whatever you wanted to have, you just need to give us the domain name as well as where exactly we need to redirect. So you can have your own domain. Even, you know, if in terms of subdomains also, you can basically ask us that, you know, some kind of subdomain if you are looking forward to. Okay, so if it is available, definitely we'll happy to give the subdomains.
Yeah, so Dr. Sylvia Cole, as Agam said, if you already have your own domain name, you can give it to them and they will configure it accordingly
Yeah.
for your website. And if you don't have a domain name, you can run your show on Cloudera website as a normal user, or you can go pro and buy a domain and then go as a professional.
Yeah, so my recommendation is start with, you know, subdomain. Once you are accustomed to things, you know, then only go for your own domain. Like, you know, why to invest things? Because, you know, you will get much more network effect on Crowdera than compared to other websites. Because we have an inbuilt engine which will basically learn about the users and target on day-to-day basis. So that's how, you know, the things will work. And if you go for the pro version, so you should have your audience very specific to things, and then the redirection might take longer in terms of maturing your own audience.
Yes, Dr. Sylvia, if you have your own domain, you can go pro
Yeah.
with Cloudera. And the only thing is you'll have to pay nominal fee for that.
Yes.
Any other query, question?
Okay, so just a brief about, you know, Crowdera. So basically, Crowdera 100 million impacted, 1 million live, 100k users across the globe. So these users can be yours if you are directly registered to Crowdera. So definitely that will help in terms of donor reach out. We have a presence of 150 countries. Like, you know, the fastest raise was 3 weeks. We have raised like 250k in 3 weeks time also. And highest is like 500k altogether. 48 hours is our fastest, like for many medical emergencies in India. And it's a big sum for somebody to save a life. Approximately 1500 nonprofits uses our platform to raise money. And we have a 52, you know, fundraising teams who instantly started. So like, you know, one organization onboarded and instantly you can have a multiple supporter onboarded on the platform. So that's the brief in terms of how exactly the network effect can kick in. The whole thing is basically, we believe in abundance starts with giving, and we are envisioning a giving economy. That's where, you know, Crowdera is moving forward. So that's all from my side. Here is my contact number. I'm available for anything, like anything, even for the personal stuff, if you wanted to contact.
So later that I have my own domain, can I still go pro? Yes, we said yes. Then it says, will you still help with setup?
Yeah, definitely. So like, you know, the only thing is you need to register on Crowdera. For setting up and those kind of thing, you just need to pay that nominal fee and our team will be happy to help. Yeah, no problem. Pleasure.
All right. Anybody else, or shall we close it? That's enough from your side, Agam, or you want to add something?
Yeah, that's all.
That's all. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So
I hope it's a good learning experience for everyone. And if you have any other question, feel free to write me and hit me up over the email or maybe on a WhatsApp.
Yeah. So you all have my email ID, Agam's email, contact number. So whatever help is required, do let us know. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you, Agam, for enlightening with your inputs. And thank you all the attendees for your valuable time and listening to Agam so patiently and understanding what he has to offer. So let's give it a call. Have a good day, morning, evening, wherever you are. Good night, and see you very soon again with Agam, with a new topic, with a new box of knowledge. Thank you so much. Yeah. All right, Agam.
Yeah. Thank you. Bye-bye.